football captain of Indian team, the recipient of prestigious Arjuna Award, not only Arjuna Award, even Padma Shri Award, and we are proud to have such a personality like Bhaichung Bhutia in our team. The Sikkim feels proud that he has chosen this different arena, the field of political arena. We are proud to him to have like person like Bhaichung Bhutia in our team. In the same way, we have Mr. Imran Subba. He is a research scholar. And we have Dr. Balis. And in the same way, we have Mr. Yogendra Rai, engineer by profession. A new regional political party in Sikkim. And the name, the most important part of that regional party is Hamro Sikkim Party.
Before I start, I'd like to clarify, the name of the party is Hamro Sikkim Party. The spelling goes H-A-M-R-O, Sikkim Party. Hamro Sikkim Party means in English, our party. So that's the meaning of it. This party obviously was formed by people of Sikkim, and we would like to dedicate this party to people of Sikkim. It's taken me over 20 years now to build a name and reputation through playing football. So I can assure and promise to people of Sikkim and India as well that I won't let this name and reputation down through politics. That's my promise. Obviously, when we take up issue, Hamro Sikkim Party, when we take up the issues and problems of Sikkim, I can assure you that Hamro Sikkim Party will have very clean, very integrated, very clean people who are going to come up and speak about the issues to people in Delhi, looking eye to eye and walking confidently and having no problems. So that is what Hamro Sikkim will be able to do it. I hope my joining politics would inspire a lot of young generation to come up in Sikkim as well as in India as well. So I think it's important that good people should come forward and get into the dirty part of politics to really clean the system. So if you want to clean the system, I think you need to get into the system to really clean it. I think the number one problem we definitely have in Sikkim is the corruption. I think there's a huge corruption happening in Sikkim today. In fact, the government of Sikkim passed a notification a few years ago banning, not allowing Central Bureau of Investigation to come into Sikkim. So I would request the Honorable CM to kindly lift this notification as soon as possible and allow investigation to come in. The second most important thing for us is the unemployment in Sikkim. I think today Sikkim, in terms of unemployment ratio, I think we are the second most unemployed in terms of percentage state in India. We are also the highest suicide rate cases in India today. Also, what we really notice is a lot of bureaucrats and officers who are with close relationship with the ruling government are getting extensions beyond their retirement. You know, 1 year, 2 years, but there are some cases which are even given extension for 10, 15 years. I think this is very, very unfair to get that kind of extension because you're not really encouraging people downwards, bureaucrats working below you to reach the highest level. Today, the biggest challenge also for Sikkim is lack of leadership. I think there is very less good leaders in Sikkim. In fact, our constitution, we put it in our constitution that anybody who holds the office, either MLA, ministers, or CM, or a party post holder is going to get only 2 terms. So if a minister, MLA, or CM wins 2 terms, after 2 terms, they're not allowed to contest.
Yeah, I think Northeast ka thoda de deta hu. I think hum log ka ye press conference announcement Delhi mein karna hai is because hum log Sikkim bhi ek Northeast state hai and lot of our issues just Northeast mein jo issues hai, Sikkim mein jo issues hai, all the issues are or sanctions jo bhi aur Delhi se hota hai, any policies jo bhi hai Delhi se hi grant hota hai. So that was why we did a press conference Delhi mein, so that people in Delhi also hear us and bring Northeast and Sikkim's issues into mainstream India. Definitely, I think Sikkim today as well, it's one of the highest suicide rate, Sikkim is the highest suicide rate case in India today. It's very, very unfortunate and we need to address that and we need to tackle it. corruption is definitely there, and I think there has to be a fair investigation to anyone involved in it. If there are serious allegations involved and serious cases put into it, I think anybody should be open to investigation. We're not saying that you're corrupt, but be open to investigation. That is too early to...
No.